Here we come, ladies and gentlemen, look high and above for your United States Army Golden Knights.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. There ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say,
is inbound for the first pass of today's performance. As the aircraft crosses overhead, the Jumpmaster gives a cross-arm signal of hot target, signifying the airspace is clear and that it is safe to jump. The jumpers are out and the smoke is on. As these jumpers fly their bodies together, they're gauging their speed, distance, and rate of closure. Contact has been made and the 14-inch mahogany baton has been exchanged. These jumpers now prepare to deploy their main parachutes. And there you have the high-flying black and gold of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Mr. Charlie Hillis, former team leader of the Eagles Aerobatics team and parachute manufacturer Mr. Steve Snyder, exchanged the first baton in 1958. To turn right, the jumper simply pulls down on the right steering line. As these jumpers will near the ground, they will pull down on both steering lines simultaneously for the safest, softest possible landing. Watch the minor corrections used in order to obtain a dead center landing. If you have any questions about the many opportunities in America's first team, the U.S. Army, feel free to contact your local Army recruiter who is here at the show today, or give us a call at 1-800-US-ARMY. Jumpmaster is looking out the left side of the aircraft. He gets a cross-arm signal of hot target. He then gives a thumbs-up signal, signifying that the jumper is clear to jump. He completes his final gear checks at the rear of the aircraft. Ladies and gentlemen, please do not be alarmed when this first parachute begins to streamer. The jumper is now accelerating earthward at speeds in excess of 90 miles per hour. It would be impossible for this jumper to survive a landing under this parachute, so it must release it completely, return to free fall, and open his main parachute. The reserve or auxiliary parachute used by the Golden Knights is also a flexible wing glider, such as the one you see here. However, there are some differences. It is slightly smaller in wing surface area and is white in color. It has a much greater forward inherent airspeed of up to 30 miles per hour. To become a Golden Knight, each individual must first achieve 100 free fall parachute jumps, be enlisted in the Army, and have a clean military and civilian record prior to applying for the annual Golden Knights assessment and selection. By pulling on this lanyard, he or she can ignite the smoke immediately upon exiting the aircraft while in free fall or under canopy. Unlike the military jet team, the United States Army Parachute Team is comprised mostly of non-commissioned officers. The 89 men and women of the Golden Knights come from various jobs throughout the Army to spend 3 to 5 years on one of the major sections of the team. On this final run, you'll experience the excitement of a stack-out maneuver. Watch for their perfectly timed exits and their simultaneous openings. The jumpers are exiting the aircraft and igniting their smoke. They fly to their designated opening point, and they all wait to pull on the team leader who initiates the waterfall-like opening sequence. And there you have the high-flying black and gold of your United States Army Parachute Team, the Golden Knights. Now, as you may have guessed, these jumpers are faced with a unique situation, a traffic jam in the sky. These jumpers must gain vertical separation in order to allow for individual approaches to the target area. This is accomplished by pulling down on the front part of the parachute and spiraling down at speeds in excess of 60 miles per hour, checking his distance and speed across the ground. He then flies a downwind leg, a base leg 90 degrees to the target, and then faces into the wind for a final approach. It takes a great deal of concentration in order to land dead center on the target. The jumper keeps a close eye on the windsock located in the target area. Once on final approach, the jumper then shifts all his concentration to a small black dot located in the center of the orange X. As the jumpers near the target, watch the minor corrections used in obtaining a dead center landing. Moments ago, these jumpers were more than 2 miles overhead, thanks in part to the advanced aerodynamic design of these Ram Air parachutes. It is the job of the bottom jumper, who is the navigator, to relay altitude readings to the pilot. If you thought landing one parachute was hard, watch closely as they bring the biplane into the target area. As the biplane nears the ground, you may hear the command break as the jumpers separate prior to the landing. And riders, 1, 2, stand up landings.
2017 air show season. All members of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our performance for the day. And on behalf of the entire team, I would like to thank each and every one of you for being such a warm and receptive airborne audience.
In closing, I leave you with this final thought. In the future, may all of your days be prosperous and your nights golden.
The Golden Knights, the Precision Parachute Demonstration Team, from your United States Army. A nice job there by the Golden Knights. And a nice job there by my good buddy Jay Rabbit.